After several years of brutal civil war, Horus and his forces finally arrive at the Sol system. Can he kick his dad out of the Imperial Palace before Rabute Gilliman shows up fashionably late to the battle? Find out as we get up to speed with our Siege of Terra catch-up. Spoiler alert, switch off now if you don't want to know what happens. Horus makes light work of the defensive fleets in the void and becomes the first supervillain to capture the moon. Now, Horus has promised Mortarion that he can be the first to set foot on Terra, but this enrages the usually calm and peaceful Angler. The initial assaults go well, and Perturabo launches an attack on the Lionsgate spaceport. He captures it, but Dawn claims that losing it was all part of his plan. The next time we see Dawn, he's fighting against Fulgrim, running the Phoenician through with a sword, only to discover that the Demon Primarch can't be killed. Fulgrim grows weary of all the actual fighting, and takes his legion out to wreak their own brand of horror upon Terra. The Emperor offers Magnus the chance to rejoin the Loyalists, but Magnus turns the offer down, so Vulcan beats him up. Don't tell anyone, though. Nobody knows that Vulcan is on Terra. Next, Horus decides on a change of personnel, replacing Perturabo with Mortarion. Perturabo takes this badly and leaves the battle without even handing the keys over to his brother. Jagatai Khan gets bored of sitting around. He jumps on his bike and launches an assault on the Lionsgate spaceport. Mortarion hasn't even finished redecorating yet when the two brothers fight, with the Khan banishing Nurgle's chosen Primarch. Then, at the Eternity Gate, we have two championship clashes. Firstly, the Noble Sanguinius takes on Kabanda, a winged demon infused with the power of Khorne. Then Noble Sanguinius takes on Angron, a winged demon infused with the power of Khorne. Sanguinius wins both bouts, then goes for a sit-down and a cup of tea. And that's where we are as we arrive at the end and the death.